Fatboy Slim, number one in the UK dance album chart. He's also number one in the indie album chart and the R&B chart as well. This week's Videotech special guest, Biss, got together 2 years ago. At the time, almost every record company in the UK tried to sign them. Finally, they struck a deal with the Beastie Boys American label, Grand Royale, and since then they've been touring the States. They are now back to conquer the UK. I'll be talking to them about that in just a moment. But first, here's the track that started it all. Pleasure to welcome you to Videotech.
Thank you.
Now, for those people that haven't met you yet, who's who? Who's the B, who's the I, who's the S?
Well, I'm
Ryan.
Sci-Fi Steven,
yeah. So I'm an S, but they have none of the proper initials.
I'm Amanda, and I'm in the middle all the time, so I'll be the I.
Yeah. John, left, right, in fact.
Yeah. Now, a couple of years ago, you were like the first unsigned band on Top of the Pops. Mm-hmm. Mass media frenzy, every record company was trying to sign you. What was that like?
Funny. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's so long ago, it seems like it's and well in the past, you know, we've kind of moved on from that, but I don't know.
It was good going around all the different record companies and you get all the free CDs, so it got like all our family's Christmas presents. That was good.
Now they know.
So what happened after that?
Well, pretty much, we signed to Ouija Records here, which was kind of, we made a conscious decision to not sign to a major label, which kind of has its pros and cons, but we went for an independent label to have more control and freedom over what we do, and it's partly why we're still here, because we haven't really had too much success in Britain since we were on Top of the Pops, but we've had success in Japan and America, and the fact that we've come back here, we've got a new single now on an independent label still, it's kind of cool that we're still around, because we're still really young, but we've been about for 3 years already, so... Yes.
So what happens in America? I believe you signed to the Beastie Boys label.
Yeah.
What do the Americans think of you?
I think they're getting into it. I mean, it's such a hard thing to crack America, you know, because it's a bit, you know, a million countries in one. Mm. You have to sort of spread yourself across. But it's really good being on their label because, I mean, instant credibility, you know, free clothes, free records.
Always good.
People just, that's all they talk to us about, really.
Have you met the Beastie Boys?
Have you?
No, of course we have, they're our bosses.
They tell us to get to work, you know? Crack the whip.
It's just such a difference, because usually when you go to meet a record label, you walk in and you'll sit around a table, it's all very formal, but we're into Grand Royal, it's like Mike D sitting on the floor eating a pizza. It's just like, right, so... And they didn't really talk about anything, because they kind of knew about us, whereas it's weird meeting all these labels that didn't actually know that much about us, and makes you wonder about it, but Grand Royal have always just likes us and likes her music, so.
Well, they have got you working hard. You got the new single. I think let's take a look. So, guys, that's the new single, Euro Disco. Mm-hmm. Kind of 80s feel to it. Are you retro addicts?
No, I think we're surprised, I think, that everyone says that, you know, because it's like Duran Duran, the new Duran Duran, and it was never a conscious decision to make it sound like Duran Duran.
No, I think people are saying it's 80s because it's a kind of fun pop song and they associate that with the 80s. It just shows you how bland the 90s have probably been, but I don't really see it as being 80s. It's quite more futuristic, and we've been using a lot of technology in this song, which they didn't really use in the 80s. So
the only 80s thing about it is that Simon Le Bon has been teaching me how to sing, so that's come through at all.
You wish, you
but
wish.
That's our celebrity sort of, you know, moment of fame.
That's
at the minute.
A bit cool.
It's also a lie.
Big up to Simon.
Oh, this was in his dreams, actually.
Yeah, oh, sorry. Yeah, I have problems separating it.
You've got quite a sexy new look in that vid, though. From the last
why are you not looking
around.
At me?
Amanda, not you guys.
With a conscious debatable. No, it's really weird, because the last time we were in the public eye was, like, 2.5 years ago, and I don't know, I've just lost touch with that and stuff. And I've been touring so much that I lost weight from jumping around the stage too much, so...
And she also took sexy lessons.
Well, hey. And I learned how to put makeup on for the first time in my life.
So are you going to be jumping around on stage any more soon, with the tour coming up, or...?
Just bits and bobs. We're playing on the 29th of October.
It's
too late.
You missed that one.
But we're hopefully going to try and get a big tour sorted out for the album coming out, which will be early next year. And we're going to New York to play a big showcase thing for Grand Royal, actually.
Oh, wow.
So I'll send your regards to Mike B.
I thought you were going to send me a ticket, yeah.
Well, you can if you want.
I'll carry the bag. Well, guys, it's been great to meet you.
Thank you.
Wish you all the best, and hopefully I'll see you touring the UK soon.
Yes, yeah, we will.
Thanks for having us on.
I'll see you after the break when we've got a brand new set of High Flies, and of course, that new top 10.